yesterday we had seen the position vector. We had also seen that if the coordinates are x, y, z, then the length of that vector was coming out to be x square plus y square plus z square root over. Okay, and we also discussed about the direction cosines. Okay, cosines are what? The angles alpha, beta, gamma that the vector makes respectively with the x, y, and z axis. Okay, and they are also termed as L, M, N, and we also saw that L square plus M square plus N square is equal to 1. Okay, now today we will do the type of vectors, the types of vectors. Okay, and the first is the zero vector. Okay, zero. So we are doing the types of vectors. Okay, types of vectors, and the first in line is the zero vector. Zero vector. Zero vector has a zero magnitude. That means it has zero length. Okay. A vector with zero magnitude, that means it has zero length. And when will it have a zero length? When the starting and the end point is the
same.
Okay, now it's a bit confusing in the sense that if the start point and the end point is the same, So I stand here, okay, and I do not move. This is my end point also. So what happens? So if I'm standing here, I just don't move. Then in which direction did I move?
No, in no direction.
In no direction. So zero vector has got no direction, okay, and its length and its direction is zero because. Its direction is not defined because I have not moved. Okay, so my end point is the same as the starting point. That is, the start and end point are the same. Okay, the start and the end point are the same. So what happens due to that, and the direction is not defined. The direction is not defined. Now then you will say, if the direction is not defined, then what kind of a vector is this? Because a vector should have a direction. But no, it is still a vector. We'll come to the reason just very, very shortly, okay, when we go into the algebra of vectors. Okay, why it has been defined, there is a specific, very, very specific reason why it has been defined. Okay, then comes the unit vector. Unit vector, as the name suggests, a vector with magnitude unity, okay, that is 1. Okay, a vector with magnitude 1 is called a unit vector. Okay, it is called a unit vector. So let us say if A is any vector, then a unit vector in its direction is denoted by a cap. It's a conical kind of cap, right? The kind of cap that the children put on their birthdays. Okay, So it's that kind of cap. Many times, actually, in some standard textbooks, you will find they call it a roof. Normally, the professors in the US, they call it a roof. It's like a roof, right? So a roof or a cap, okay? Spelled a cap. But we in India, or a roof. We use this, so you keep on using this. Okay. Now, how do we get that? That you'll soon understand after we do one operation later, the scalar multiplication. Then you'll understand. But just for now, you just take my word for it that a cap is this vector divided by its magnitude, which can be expressed like this or simply a. We had made a point, we had made a note yesterday. I think I had made that if you remove the vector sign from the vector, that denotes its magnitude. Okay, or you put a mod with a vector mod, okay, that represents the magnitude. So it will be given by this. We'll soon understand why. I'll come back to this. Then we have co-initial vectors. So see, if here in unit vector, suppose this is my A and my unit is 1 centimeter is 1 unit, then let us say this vector is A cap. It should be in the same direction as A. A vector which is in the same direction as A, only thing is that its magnitude should be 1. Now, standard unit vectors. Standard unit vectors are what? We already know that. No? Achha, no, you do not know that. Standard unit vectors are I cap, J cap, and K cap. You have heard of them? No? So, this is the x-axis, this is y, this is z, this is the origin. Now, a unit vector
in the direction of x-axis.
Okay. The positive direction of x-axis is termed, so this vector, okay, is I cap. Okay, this is I cap. And this vector is
J cap. Okay.
And this vector is K cap. This is a convention. The unit vectors in the direction of the positive direction of x, y, and z axis, they are called I cap, J cap, and K cap. It's a standard convention that we use for the unit vectors in the positive direction of x axis, y axis, z axis. We'll soon see what is the use of that. Okay. Then we come to co-initial vectors. Co-initial vectors are the vectors with the same initial point. Okay, and what do we mean by initial point? Say I have got a vector like that, A. Okay, I have a vector like that. Another vector is, say, something like this, which is B. if they are free vectors, we have said that they can be moved parallel to themselves, same length parallel to themselves, same direction. Okay, so maybe this is also B, not parallel. I think it is parallel now.
Yes.
Now, if I shift it so that their initial points, their tails, okay, the tails, their initial points, this is initial point, this is terminal point, or this is tail, this is head. If they come together, then it is called a co-initial vector. Co-initial vector. Okay. You understand? Now we come. So all the do you understand one thing, that all the direction, all the position vectors, they are all co-initial, isn't it? All the position vectors are co-initial vectors. All the position vectors. The position vectors are co-initial vectors. Okay? All the position vectors are co-initial vectors. Why? Because how have we defined the position vectors? They have their tails at the origin, isn't it? So these maybe whatever. So they're all co-initial, no? Yeah, the standard unit vectors are also co-initial. But the trouble is that they can be shifted. So, but direction vectors cannot be shifted, in the sense that they can be shifted, yes. But they are defined rooted here. So yes, the initial vectors are also, the standard vectors are also that. So next is collinear vectors. Collinear vectors. Collinear vectors. Vectors which are parallel to the same line. Vectors parallel or anti-parallel to the same line. Vectors parallel or anti-parallel to the same line are called collinear vectors. So what do we mean to say? See, this vector and this vector, they are collinear. Also this vector. Why? Because they are parallel to some line. All of them are parallel to some line. Or you can say all of them are parallel to each other. Okay? That is collinear vectors. Collinear vectors. Okay? Okay. So we have written that? Do I erase this part? This half I am erasing. Now we come to equal vectors. Equal vectors. What are equal vectors? See, vector has two properties. So if you actually want to equate them, both the properties should be the same. they should be identical, isn't it? So
vectors which have the same magnitude, which have the same magnitude and same direction, are called equal vectors. Look, this vector and
get it. They are parallel, equal magnitude. So they are
equal vectors.
Even one of them gets violated, they'll not be equal. So their direction may be the same, but magnitude is more or less not equal. Okay? Or magnitude is the same, direction is different, not equal. Okay?
So for example, A is equal to B. A is equal to B, but a vector C is not equal to A. Correct? C is not equal to A. Also, same length, direction changes, D is also not equal to A. Why is this not equal? Magnitude is different, direction is, though the direction is same.
Right?
Magnitude is same, direction is different. Though the magnitude is the same.
Get it?
Now we come to a negative vector.
You've got a vector A, you might require its negative to be found out. ठीक है? Given a vector A, its negative vector minus A is of the same magnitude but is of the same magnitude but opposite direction. Okay. Is of the same magnitude but opposite direction. Okay. The direction becomes opposite to it. So if this is A vector, this is vector A, then this is minus A. You see? It's the same length, but just the